Hello students, good morning. In this video, we are going to discuss sources of microorganisms to food. In this topic, we will see how microorganisms enter the food or how the food gets contaminated with microorganisms. Microorganisms enter the food through various sources, which include the raw materials, water, air or dust, soil, and sewage. Microorganisms also enter the food through rodents, insects, animals, and birds. Packaging material may also contribute some microorganisms to the food. Food handlers also contribute microorganisms to the food and add microorganisms to the food. Our food mainly constitutes plants and animals. Microorganisms get into the food from natural sources and from external sources. Raw and processed foods contain different types of molds, yeasts, bacteria, and viruses. Now we will see plants as a source of microorganisms to the food. The inner healthy tissues of plants are sterile and contain very few organisms. Microorganisms are present on the surface of fruits, vegetables, and grains. The number of microorganisms is more in the damaged tissues and in the pores of some tubers, for example radish. The number and type of microorganisms depends on the plant and environment. Some plants produce natural antimicrobial metabolites, and these natural antimicrobial metabolites limit the presence of microorganisms in that particular food. The surface flora includes bacteria from different genera. For example, Pseudomonas, Alkaligenes, Flavobacterium, Micrococcus, Coliforms, and lactic acid bacteria like Leuconostoc mesenteroides, Leuconostoc dextranicum, Streptococcus faecalis, Irvinia, Bacillus, and Clostridium. The surface flora also includes molds and yeasts. The surface of a well-washed tomato may show 400 to 700 microorganisms per square centimeter, while the unwashed tomato would have several thousand microorganisms per square centimeter. The surface of unwashed cabbage may harbor 1 to 2 million microorganisms per gram, while the washed, trimmed cabbage contains 2 lakh to 5 lakh microorganisms per gram. Pathogens, especially of enteric origin, for example, Salmonella, Escherichia coli, Campylobacter, Shigella, Cyclospora, and Giardia, can be present if the soil is contaminated with untreated sewage. There are various factors that contribute to increase in microbial numbers. For example, diseases of plants, damage of the surface before, during, and after harvest, long delays between the harvesting and washing, unfavorable storage and transport conditions after harvesting and before processing can greatly increase the microbial numbers. Now, animals as a source of microorganisms to food. Skin, hair, feathers, hides, and hooves of animals are laden with microorganisms. Microorganisms are added to the food through the gastrointestinal tracts, urogenital tracts, respiratory tracts, and milk ducts in milking animals. The skin of many animals contain micrococci, staphylococci, and beta-hemolytic streptococci. Staphylococci may find their way onto the carcass and finally to the raw material. Pig or beef carcasses may carry Salmonella species. Fecally contaminated products of animals can contain enteric pathogens including Salmonella species. Animals are carriers and they can carry various pathogens such as Salmonella species, pathogenic Escherichia coli, Campylobacter jejuni, Yersinia enterocolitica, and Listeria monocytogenes. Laying birds are the suspects of carrying Salmonella enteritidis in their ovaries and therefore contaminating yolk during ovulation. Fish and shellfish carry normal microflora in the scales, skin, digestive tracts, etc. They carry pathogens such as Vibrio species like Vibrio parahemolyticus and Vibrio vulnificus. Food gets contaminated during production and processing. For example, milk gets contaminated with fecal materials on the outer surface of milking animal. Eggshells are contaminated with the fecal material. Meat is contaminated with the intestinal contents during slaughtering. Enteric pathogens from fecal materials commonly found are Staphylococcus aureus, Micrococcus species, molds, and yeasts. Now we will discuss air as a source of microorganisms to the food. Air does not contain a natural flora. Microorganisms in the air are transient. Contamination of food by air is important for two reasons, for sanitary as well as for economic reasons. Pathogens causing respiratory tract diseases are spread through the air. Spoilage organisms also may come from the air. Mold spores from the air may spoil cheese, milk, sweetened condensed milk, sliced bread, and bacon. Microorganisms enter the air through various sources like dust or lint, dry soil, sprays from streams, lakes, and oceans. Microorganisms also enter the air through the droplets from coughing, sneezing, and talking. Microorganisms are contributed to the air through the growth of sporulating molds on walls, ceilings, floors, foods, and ingredients. Air around the yeast manufacturing plant is high in yeast. Air around the dairy is high in bacteria and bacteriophages. Microorganisms that are resistant to heat and desiccation live in the air for a longer duration and they persist in the air. Mold spores are very small. They are resistant to drying and in large number, and therefore they are present in the air. Predominant microorganisms in the air include Bacillus species, Clostridium species, Micrococcus species, and Sarsina. Cocci are more numerous in the air than the rods. Asporogenous chromogenic yeasts are usually isolated from the air. The number of microorganisms in the air. On the mountaintop, the number of microorganisms is very less. Very few microorganisms are found. For example, less than 1 microorganism per cubic feet is found on the mountaintop. But in the dusty air, the number of microorganisms may be several thousand per cubic feet. The number depends on amount of movement, sunshine, humidity, location, and amount of suspended dust or spray. Dry air usually contains more microorganisms than the humid air. But if the dry air has low dust content and if the temperature is very high, then dry air with low dust content and high temperature has a low microbial level. Heavy rain or snow removes the microorganisms from the air. Microbial contamination in the air can be reduced by different ways. We can use heat or chemical treatment or electrostatic precipitation to reduce the microbial number in the air. We can use reducing the humidity level or UV light to control the microbial number in the air. Controlling dust particles in the air by filtration through cotton, fiberglass or activated carbon and then using positive air pressure also can be used to reduce the number of microorganisms in the air. This is all for this video. The remaining sources we will discuss in the next video. Thank you.